All right, Shalom. All praises and glory to Yahweh, Basham Yahweh Shai, Wahabrit Kakwadash. Double honors to the apostle, elders, a great millstone, and salutations to Joachim out there laboring in the faith. And this is Raya Kagama coming at you with another lesson going into the chariots of our salvation, as you can see the title. And pretty much, since we're nearing the final end of this age of rulership of Esau, which and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth, pretty much, the chariots, which they call unidentified aerial phenomenon or unidentifiable flying objects, are known as the vehicles of the angels, that is going to be used to deliver the Lord Yahweh Shai's elect upon his return, for our salvation. Okay. The scriptures speak about it, and pretty much like there's been numerous amounts of sightings, and it's gonna keep increasing more and more. And pretty much you can look for these chariots to be doing, acts of destruction as well as salvation, to deliver the Lord's chosen in these coming times. So I'm gonna play this clip here.
High above the earth, grouped together with no explanation. These clips show what's being described as swarms of UFOs. Earlier this year in Seoul, in South Korea, a crowd gathers to stare up beyond the skyscrapers into the sky. A group of objects hover above the center of the city for a few seconds, then they disappear. In Mexico, 3 years earlier, a very similar sight. Clearer this time, the group of white objects are baffling the people below.
Mira las esferas.
Zooming in still closer, we find that there are even smaller groupings. Over New York City last year, what looks at first like the vapor trails of aeroplanes. A closer inspection reveals there are dozens of apparent objects, seemingly arranged in some sort of formation. Just before the footage comes to an end, one of the objects appears to come much closer. Lastly, this could at first be another UFO swarm. It's in fact a group of helicopters. But the aircraft enthusiast behind this clip from Russia soon realized that following this group of flying objects was something he couldn't explain.
All right, Khan. As far as these other nations, they are afraid of these sightings because they don't know what to make of them. But we know through the spirit of Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shah that these are the same vehicles that are going to be used for the elect salvation, as well as, you can identify them in the scriptures as far as the same vehicles that beamed up the prophet Elijah, as well as to those who recognize in the spirit the prophet what's his name, Enoch, as well as Jehoshaphat. You know, when the scriptures speak about Enoch being translated, that was how he was taken into the spirit world, you know. And these are the same vehicles, you know, that's going to cover the whole earth when Yahushua returns. This is Zechariah 5:1. Then I turned and lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, a flying robe. And he said unto me, What seest thou? And I answered, I see a flying robe. The length thereof is 20 cubits, and the breadth thereof 10 cubits. Then said he unto me, This is the curse that goeth forth over the face of the whole earth. All right, so you're going to be seeing these flying robes or these flying chariots, and they're going to cover the entire sky, you know, around the time of our salvation. For everyone that stealeth shall be cut off as on this side according to it, and everyone that sweareth shall be cut off as on that side according to it. All right. So who's known as, you know, the great thief of the earth, you know, the great abomination of desolation that sweareth falsely, you know, Esau, you know, who pretty much stole lands, you know, as he stole pretty much America, and is occupying other nations' lands to steal their resources. You know, Esau is the great thief of the earth, you know. And when the chariots come for our salvation, they're also going to pretty much destroy the nation's armies that are in the midst of World War III, because Esau has been preparing for this battle. You know, Esau has been preparing for the battle with the chariots and the UFO, the so-called UFOs, because they've been keeping watch on these chariot vehicles. But they wanted to keep this information away from the public for so long, but now, you know, they are pretty much bringing this information out, as far as, you know, over at the Pentagon. And they're calling them unidentified aerial phenomena. But according to the scriptures, you know, they're identified. All right, this is Revelations 12:7. And there was war in heaven. Now, that war in heaven is not talking about, you know, war going on between the angels and the demons in the spirit world. No, this is a war that is physically going to be played out and manifested in this latter day and time. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, which the dragon represents, you know, the serpent, or the basically the beast, or the power structure of Esau. Okay. And the dragon fought and his angels and prevailed not, neither was their place found any more in heaven. All right. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. All right. So once these chariots pretty much take down Esau's military, they're going to be casted into the earth and pretty much put into captivity. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, Now has come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his anointed, for the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our power day and night. All right, which Esau has pretty much been doing since he's been in the rulership. You know, he wanted to find ways to disrupt the prophecy of us inheriting the kingdom of heaven. You know, he wanted to search out the heavens, search out the depths of the seas, to see if we could be done away with as a nation, and that for the Most High to accept him, you know. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knoweth he hath but a short time. And Esau knows he has a short time to be in rulership, which is why everything is speeding up, you know. Especially since Trump is now accomplishing the will of the elites, you know. And as far as World War III on the rise, and America's allies is slowly starting to turn against America, because America is that great harlot that the nations shall devour. Okay. This is Acts chapter 1, verse 6. When they therefore were come together, that they being the disciples, when Yahushua was raised up and resurrected before them, it said, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? All right, which this is going back 2,000 years ago when the apostles was on the scene to bring the ministry to the Israelite foreigners to be sealed with this word, with this knowledge, through the spirit of Yahushua. And they were inquiring if the kingdom was going to be restored to Israel, meaning Israel was going to have dominion in the earth again. But a lot of other things needed to take place as far as us being dispersed throughout the four corners of the earth. Esau coming into rulership to have his rulership for the last time. And then our salvation was going to be brought forth. And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit is come upon you. Ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. All right, just like we're witnesses unto Yahushua through the Holy Spirit, you know, throughout the four corners of the earth, you know, because you got all these different camps, you know, that's teaching in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, that's coming up all over the globe as prophecy is being fulfilled. And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven, as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye up gazing into heaven? This same Yahushua, which was taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. All right. So the same way that Yahushua was taken into a whirlwind through that chariot is the same way he's gonna be returning. That those same type of vehicles, except his is gonna be the fathership, so it's gonna be the largest chariot in it that's gonna fill the entire sky. This is Matthew's 24 and 30. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. I mean, as you saw in that clip, you know, these nations were scared seeing these chariots in the sky, you know, because to them they're unidentified, you know. And they can't explain why these chariots are looking over the inhabitants of the earth in the sky. But the scriptures, to those who was given this understanding, are able to know what these chariot vehicles are. All right. And in the coming times, you know, the 2/3 of our people, they're going to mourn, as well as the other nations. They're going to be in mourning when they see these chariots coming, you know, for our salvation. And they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. All right. So Yahweh Shai is coming as that angelic force. And pretty much, you know, all the nations is gonna see it, you know, and they're gonna be in great fear. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Alright? So the 144,000 is gonna be gathered from the four corners of the earth, as well as the 1/3. And that's when the kingdom of heaven is going to be established. All right. This is Psalms 104, verse 3. Who layeth the beams of his chambers and the waters, who maketh the clouds his chariot, who walketh upon the wings of the wind. Alright, so these chariots is able to, you know, make the clouds their covering, you know. And a lot of the times, you know, as far as when the Akiyama and I myself have even seen, you know, some of these chariots, they don't even make a sound, you know. This is 2 Kings 2 and 11. And it came to pass, as they still went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire, and parted them asunder. Alright, so, you know, when Elijah the prophet was being taken up into the heavens, you know, Elijah saw it, and pretty much these chariot vehicles pretty much had different colors of light that he saw, and they took Elijah into the heavens, and Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven, the same way that Yahweh Shai was taken up in Acts the first chapter in the 9th verse. And Elijah saw it, and he cried, "My father, my father, the chariot of Israel and the horsemen thereof." And he saw him no more, and he took hold of his own clothes and rent them in two pieces. Okay, so that's how you know, during our captivity, you know, the Jake used to sing a song called "Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, coming by to carry me home." Well, this was the chariot that, you know, our forefathers understood, you know. This is Revelation 11, and I'm going to get straight to the point. This is Revelation 11 and 12. And I heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, "Come up hither." And they ascended up to heaven in a cloud, and their enemies beheld them. All right.
As a matter of fact, I'm going to start up above. This is Revelations 11 and 10. And they that dwell upon the earth shall rejoice over them and make merry and shall send gifts one to another, because these two prophets tormented them that dwell on the earth. Which those two prophets represents the northern and the southern kingdom of the nation of Israel. And when we were in our power and our glory, we tormented these other nations, you know, because our power, Yahweh, was with us. And once again, they're going to be tormented now that his spirit is coming back upon his elect. And after 3 days and a half, the spirit of life from Yahweh, Bashem Yahushua, entered into them, and they stood upon their feet, and great fear fell upon them which saw them. All right. And that's the reason why, you know, as more and more of these prophecies unfold, when they see us out there, they become more and more agitated and more fearful of our presence. You know, because they can feel in their spirit that, you know, pretty much this, that things is about to get ready to happen that they can't pretty much have a full grasp on. This is Wisdom of Solomon 5:1. Then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of such as have afflicted him, and made no account of his labors. And that's taking place, you know, pretty much right now, as you know, you got the Akim out there laboring and pushing his word. You know, that's us standing in our in great boldness, you know, through the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, bringing out, you know, the truth according to the prophecies and his word. You know, when they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear and shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, so far beyond that they look for. Right, because when those chariots come to gather the elect, it's going to be a strange thing accounted to 2/3 of our people as well as these other nations. And they repented, and they repenting and groaning for anguish, a spirit shall say within themselves, this is he whom we had sometimes in derision and a proverb of reproach. All right, especially these other nations, when they see the strangeness of our salvation, you know, because, you know, we've been cast down as a people. And now pretty much a heavenly occurrence just took place. When they gonna see you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Natives and confusion of faith Israelites being taken up into the clouds, you know? It says, we fools accounted his life madness and his end to be without honor. How is he numbered among the children of Yahweh, and his lot is among the saints? Therefore have we erred from the way of truth, and this is mainly going to the 2/3, and the light of righteousness have not shined unto us, and the sun of righteousness rose not upon us. Alright, so that's going to be, you know, their portion, which is that thermonuclear fire that they're going to be left in, and they're going to consider all of these things that we've been bringing out through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, you know. As far as refusing the word of the prophets when we was out there laboring and bringing out this word, you know. So that pretty much sums it up as far as you know, the chariots, which, you know, these nations, you know, Esau, who call them unidentifiable aerial phenomenon, you know, pretty much these are the chariots that are going to be for our salvation. This is 1 Thessalonians 4 and 13. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, meaning those that have died in the faith, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. All right, so, you know, you're going to have martyrs who pass in the faith, who are going to be put to death, who believe and have works through Yahweh Shai. They're going to pass, but they still have hope because their works is going to follow after them. For if we believe that Yahweh Shai died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Yahweh Shai will Yahweh bring with him. All right, so when Yahweh Shai returns, you know, those same spirits, those same individuals is going to be with Yahweh Shai at his coming. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of the Most High. And the dead in Yahweh Shai shall rise first. Alright? So when Yahweh Shai comes, you know, those that died in the faith, who are his part of his chosen,
part of his elect, you know, they're going to be with him at his coming. They're going to be the first resurrected. They're going to be the first to receive those renewed spiritual bodies, you know. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds. All right, so now you know it's not talking about literal clouds, but those chariot vehicles, the chariots of Israel, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. And we can take comfort in this, knowing that this is a future prophecy getting ready to take place, as, you know, we're nearing America's destruction, which is the hopeful elect salvation. And with that, I'll say, Shalom.